I'm sorry.
And this is Machine Head from the band Bush.
Oh.
This is...
I thought it was the opposite. I thought the band was Machine Head and the song was Bush.
No, it says Bush Machine Head.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's what they gave me. Yep.
Okay.
Isn't there a band called Machine Head?
There's a band called Machine Head. I don't think they have a song called Bush, though.
Oh, okay.
The name of the band is Bush. The name of the song is Machine Head. And this is for, which alliance is this?
Sin and Glory.
Sin and Glory!
Yeah.
For Tommy Topical political commentary, you can hit me up at Middle America with Vinny and Sori. I am wearing a shirt from one of my bandmates. This is Jay Dispirited. True. Go check him out. Go check him out. One of the greatest guitarists of all time. Okay, there are multiple ways to get your song reviewed, dear listener. My favorite way is the community option. $1 to get you in a Patreon where you get to meet many people, including the leader of this amazing alliance. That's the big homie Christopher Cope. Zope. And you pull your points together, and then you get the ability to listen to get your song listened to, which is why we're doing Machine Head right now. On top of that, I've got to put this out on the secret page on the band because I wanted to release like that 34-second clip that Sarcast had up there. So once that gets released, you also get to do that if you get to listen to the first 34 seconds of our song. No vocals yet, though. On Patreon. So you get all that good stuff. You get shirts. I mean, it's a wonderful place to be. If you don't like the community option, you're filthy capitalist like Sori, $125 gets you straight to the head of the line, VinandSoriMerch at gmail.com at PayPal, and then you get to have your song listened to without doing it with your teammates. But I, of course, like the community option because I'm a collectivist. And with that being said, Bush, Machine Head, let's go. opening riff, and it sounds so familiar. That
Oh, really?
Yeah, I don't know if that's a common riff that was around in 94, but I felt like I remember that riff, but I don't know. I really like this song. I like the lyric writing.
Talking about Machine Head, is it like one of those concept items, albums where we're talking about, like...
Well, he's the verse lines are all talking about the verse lines are always talking are talking about
breathing,
feeling, emotion, tied to a wheel. Our fingers got to feel bleeding through a tourniquet. Smile, I spin on a whim. I slide to the right. I felt you like electric light. For our love, for our fear, for our rise against the years and years and years. Mm-hmm. So verse one is about feeling and emotion, and then you get to the chorus, and he talks about a machine head. But then he says he walks away from it. And then verse 2, deaf, dumb, dirty, starting to deserve this, leaning on my conscience wall. Blood is like wine, unconscious all the time. If I had it all again, I'd change it all. So it looks like he did something wrong here, and now he's paying for it. I like that line, starting to deserve this. Mm-hmm. Why do you? You look like you like it.
No, it's just... No, I don't. I just can see how you do. Starting to deserve it. I don't know, because you always say things like, you know, there's no rest for the wicked, or, you know, some people aren't meant to be happy.
I don't say that anymore.
No, you haven't said it in a while. Why are you still saying it? You feel all right?
Well, before you, I was like, I'm just not meant to be happy. And I was at peace with that. You know that that thing I put on Instagram with the bad guy Skeletor? He's like,
yeah.
Everybody thinks you're an asshole, and then it's like, I'm at peace. That's like my favorite meme of all time. I'm gonna
honest
find it.
To goodness, like
I love that
when
meme so
you
much.
Are in that space where you do something that makes me really, really angry, and I can tell you're at complete peace with it, it makes me so much more angry.
I know. Sori wants me to be miserable because she's mad at me.
I'm like...
When you've experienced degrees of misery, hopelessness, and pain that I've endured, a little blip on the Sori radar is absolutely nothing. Like,
when I bring up his meal, I'm just gonna set it on the desk and I'm gonna say it.
Yeah.
And he's like, look, I got a meal.
Right, for years there was no meal. I was out there risking my life for my country.
Oh, no.
I'd come home and nothing in the oven, for God's sake. I said, you could have at least warned me. She's like, where were you? I'm like, just saving the world. All right, back to your regularly scheduled program. I like this guy's writing. Blood is like wine, unconscious all the time. If I had it all again, I'd change it all. I'm trying to find that meme for everybody.
See, I like the breathe in, breathe out part.
I figured you would. Because that's like the type of stuff that you like. It just sounds like you're probably going to turn it into a relationship song, I'm sure. Oh, go ahead.
No, I wasn't, actually. Well, initially I was thinking, okay, like breathe in, breathe out. Because sometimes, like, you kind of have to, like, that's supposed to be something that's involuntary and you don't have to tell yourself to breathe in, breathe out.
That's
but if you're in a bad spot or you're in a, you know, a transition, or then you have to bring yourself back to the basics, like just breathe in, breathe out. Also, when people get super angry, they kind of, like, count to 10, just breathe, you know what I mean? Stuff like that. And then, like, I was thinking, like, for 2 seconds, I was like, oh, I wonder, like, you know, because when you're delivering, they always tell you, you know, keep breathing. So, like, maybe this would be a cool song to just kind of, like, play quietly in the background. But the moment that I pictured, like, being in delivery and having
As you're
music,
delivering?
No, like...
To hear this song while you're delivering?
I didn't say as I was delivering, but when you're going through, like, the contractions. And then, like, for the 2 seconds that I thought about it, I immediately thought it was a horrible idea.
Bad play. It's a bad play.
I would get very annoyed. Anyway, I don't think that the Skeletor one was posted there. I think you put it on Facebook.
I'm pretty certain I posted the Skeletor thing on
I'm pretty sure that would be pretty easy Instagram to find by just typing Skeletor.
Because Lindsay had she messaged me about it. But anyway.
Oh, okay.
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. There it is right there. I was right. Person. Oh. You're such an opinionated asshole. Me. I am at peace with myself.
He's sitting on his throne of bones.
Okay. So,
oh,
well,
boy, oh boy.
So I think this is probably about not having emotions, which would be Machine Head, which is why he's walking away from it. It's like that contrast.
So the green to red is he was thinking before, but he put it all on stop.
Well, I think green.
The feeling,
to,
I mean.
Well, green to red is I'm taking.
Calm to anger.
I'm taking that to mean that when you operate in the Machine Head, when you have the Machine Head and you're operating in that sort of mechanistic way, that's how you make decisions. Oh, it's green light, I can go. Red light, I can't. And you're not really feeling, which obviously in traffic, that's actually pretty helpful. Mm-hmm. Like there are times when you're not just supposed to go by your emotions. Your emotions can get you killed.
Yeah.
You know, people tell you all the time, don't drive when you're angry. Like that time when you drove off and I was like, hey, how about you not do that? But homeboy had gotten you like over the edge.
We weren't together at the time.
Homeboy
was
got
in my past
you.
Relationship.
He got you over the edge and you
like,
were gone.
Nope.
You were gone. I was like, oh my God.
Sometimes I think about that, and if I replay that moment, it's actually a pretty scary moment because I was like.
It's a freaking horrifying, horrifying moment for me.
I took off and I was driving erratically on back roads, and I like thought the road continued going straight, but it actually took a very sharp turn, and I flew off the road into the bushes, but like miraculously or not, there was like a dirt road right where I went through the bushes at. And you couldn't see that dirt road. Like when I went through, I didn't hit, I probably would have wrapped that car, right, that thing right around a tree. If there was any trees there, I don't think I would have made it because I was going really fast. I was like, oh my gosh. But sometimes I replay it now and I'm like.
Yeah, it was a bad moment. But, mashallah tabaraka, you're here. So
I still remember seeing you.
Yeah, let's talk about something else.
No, no, so, you were standing on the porch.
Yeah. So yeah, green to red. So you're operating the Machine Head. It's just like, you know, you're.
Yeah.
You know, it's everything is mechanistic and plotted out for you. And I think he's trying to, like, get outside of that and. Mm-hmm. Actually operate from his feelings, but apparently when he did that, he made some sort of error because his conscience is like starting to crumble and he feels like he did something wrong. So maybe it's
oh,
about
no.
trying to start. It, maybe it's about trying to strike that balance between, you know, hey, I want to go out and explore, or I want to, you know, feel how I feel without, like, you know, having some logical, rational reason for why I'm doing what I'm doing. But there are times when it's good to, you got to find a way to combine logic and reason with your emotions and all the rest of it, because you end up doing things that you would regret.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that that's what he's talking about. But I really like this song, and I like the way the guy. What's this guy's name?
I'm surprised you liked it because it was pretty repetitive.
It was repetitive. Gavin Rossdale is the guy's name, is the singer. Well, I'm assuming the guy who wrote it is the singer, but what can you do? So I like the way that he sings because it's kind of technical. It's like hitting notes, but at the same time, there's still like emotion and feeling mm-hmm. in the song, which I really like.
But there's
like.
Some chill to it, too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yep.
It was a little bit repetitive, and because of that, there's not a lot of lyrics to, like, really deconstruct.
Yeah.
So that bothers me a little bit, but I love the guitar line, and I love the way they put the song together,
mm-hmm.
and I really like verse 2. Deaf, dumb, dirty, starting to deserve this, leaning on my conscience wall. Blood is like wine, unconscious all the time. If I had it all again, I'd change it all. I wonder how many people would actually do, like, are there actual things where if you had to do it over again, you'd change, or would you leave everything exactly the same? See, I would
I would change things.
I would, there's one thing I would change in my life. Well, no, there's four events in my life I would change if I could change them. So yeah, I guess that, but none of them have anything to do with relationships. Like, relationship-wise, I would do everything exactly the same way. But then there's...
You would have done all your high school stuff the same?
Yeah. Yeah. I wouldn't want to mess with anything that would lead me to this moment with you. So, Sorry. Ladies, but it is what it is. If it could have in any way changed me being in this moment with you, I wouldn't do it.
Oh, well, yeah, but let's say you still land in the moment, like...
Well, obviously you don't want to hurt people or whatever. I mean, I think they're going to be fine. They're going to be fine without me in their life.
For me, I just wish that I would have, like... Because I wanted to just be married and be in love. And, like, I think that I wasted, like, a lot of time. For instance, like, if I was at some event and they were, like, teaching something, I didn't pay attention so much to the teaching because I was like, I wonder if he's here. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. As I wasted time, like, on stuff like that, I also, there's one situation that I think of a lot from the Bible college that I went to. So the woman that ran the Bible college was very, like, she was very overbearing. And
that woman was a complete fascist.
Yeah. And so she, basically what happens, I think that, you know, if your leader is like that, then the people that are just beneath them that like run everything can end up becoming embittered. And so the lady that was beneath her that was in charge of like all of our cleaning was like a nightmare. And she was so strict. Vin thinks that I'm strict on the kids with the cleaning. You have no friggin' clue. How it was. I'm so lenient and relaxed, like, it's unbelievable. So, anyway, that lady really bugged me because she was just really hard on everybody, and she was always sour and miserable, and, so anyway, there was, like, a lot of people had gotten sick in the college, and so it was just kind of going around because nobody really left, like, we all had to stay in one area. So, she had everybody open up all their windows, and she was gonna leave them open for the duration of chapel. And chapel could be anywhere from an hour to 2 hours long. But it was in the winter, it was cold. And so the heater was just friggin' burning through that oil to run. But she was thinking she was doing a service to get the sickness out and then, you know, and so the leader was like, why are all, like literally like this. She goes, why are all the windows open right now? And so all of us students were just kind of like, because we all knew it was her. And so she said, and the thing is, like, when she was talking to us, she was always like, but when she was talking to that lady, yeah, she was like, she's like, I had all the students open up their windows so that way the, you know, it could air out the thing. She goes, and that was supposed to stay like that through the entire, she goes, you go over there and shut all those windows right now. And like,
she blitzed in front of all those people?
Everybody. And she did, and she was so rude about it. You go, like, I felt like she was, like, like bossing her around in a way that was completely inappropriate to boss a grown woman. Like, if it was a child,
that would be inappropriate to talk to a child.
I have some space. I know, babe. I know how you feel about that. But I feel like that, like, especially
training young fascists for tomorrow.
Stop! I feel like it's way worse when a grown woman speaks to another grown woman that way. Like, I was like, what is happening here?
Why? Why is it worse?
Because, like, a parent can kind of, like, get frustrated with a kid and be like, why would you do that? Like, but it's like, it's a kid. Just like I can punish, I can put my kid in timeout. I'm not going to put an adult in timeout. Like, there's certain things that just, like, even if she would have, like, reamed out a kid like that, I don't think that it would be good, but it's worse to me that it was a grown woman. So anyway,
happened to you as a grown person, it would affect you more than if it happened to you as a kid?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So as a kid, you'd be like, oh, this is cool.
No, I wouldn't have liked it.
But as a grown woman, you'd be like, I'm angry.
You know what? We got reamed out on stuff all the time when we were kids. It's part of being a kid. Like, but then you hit a certain age, it doesn't happen to you anymore. And this happened to her as a grown woman, and I thought, oh my gosh. And like, part of me felt like I should stand up right there in the middle of the chapel in front of everybody and say, that was completely unchristlike to talk to her like that. And I don't think that, you know, I think that you owe her an apology. Because nobody stood up to this woman. What did the woman say?
What'd she say when you said that?
No, I said I didn't say that. That's one of the things that I go back to a bunch of times.
Oh, that's
and
what
I wish
you would have
I
changed.
Had said
that's
something.
That's what you would have changed.
Yep. But there was too many things that were riding on it because my father said I wasn't gonna stay in the college, I was gonna end up leaving.
Good
and if I would have stood up and said that, it's very likely she would have kicked me out of the school.
Or she might have repented. She might have been like, oh, that's terrible.
Yeah, nobody stood up to her.
This entire 11 minutes, ladies and gentlemen, came from this one line, if I could do it again, I'd change it all.
What? I didn't talk for 11 minutes.
No, I did too. It was that little section.
Oh.
Everything is a criticism with you. God almighty. Let's get out of this song before more people die. Go ahead. What do you give this song?
I liked it. It was a 9.
This is a 9.7 for me. I would have given it a 9.9, but I gave Cradle of Filth a 9.8, and I can't score this higher than Cradle of Filth. So even though it deserved a higher score, I'm not going to. The Bush fans are going to be mad at me, but it is what it is. I'm just a human being.
Yeah.
Vit out.
Sorry, Al.
Gone.
Machine.